Assalamu alaikum and very good morning to all my dear students. Class 11 Accountancy. Students, last time we have discussed about the rules of the account. Rules we have seen. Rules of accounts. Students, first account was personal account, second account was real account, and third one was nominal account. Students, these are the three different types of accounts are there: personal account, real account, and nominal account. Now the rules of the personal account, as we have discussed last time also, debit the receiver, as well as credit the giver. This is the rule of the personal account. Debit the receiver and credit the giver. Now students, real account rules are: debit what comes in, and credit what goes out. Students, debit what comes in, credit what goes out, rules of real account. Nominal account rules are: debit all the expenses as well as losses, and credit all the incomes as well as profits. Students, iske base pe hume journal entries likhni hai. Three accounts are there: personal account, debit the receiver, and credit the giver. Here, real account, debit what comes in and credit what goes out. And nominal account, debit all the expenses as well as losses of the business, and credit all the income and profits of the business. Now students, let me just write, suppose, one transaction here. Purchase goods of rupees 10,000. Student, मैंने एक transaction लिखा है यहाँ पे, purchase goods of rupees 10,000. अब इसकी two fold effect हम देते थे, अगर वो देंगे तो कैसे होगा? Two fold effect I hope you know that. Now two fold effect in the sense, first we will see whether the transaction is economic or not. ये एकदम perfectly economic transaction है, because goods you have already purchased which directly affect the business. So students, this is economic transaction. Now second step, is it cash transaction or credit transaction? It's a cash transaction, because party's name is not there, as well as purchase goods of rupees 10,000, persons the from whom you have purchased this, the name of that creditor is not given here, supplier is not given here. So because party's name is not there, though cash and check word is not given, but still it's a cash transaction. One more thing students, though because it's a cash transaction, one thing can be possible: either cash will come or cash will go. Now when you purchase the goods, it means that goods will come, so it means cash will go. So I will write down here first effect: cash goes out, cash goes out. Now students, when cash goes out, then cash will not come. Two things cannot be done at same time: come and go. So now after cash, what will be our next step? Goods and asset. Goods or asset comes in or goes out. Just check please. Here in this transaction, you have purchased the goods. It means that goods goes out or goods comes in. Yeah, it's purchase means goods comes in. So I will write down here: goods comes in. Now students, already we gave two effects. ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द रूल्स ऑफ दिस थ्री अकाउंट्स, जस्ट चेक थ्री अकाउंट्स प्लीज, एंड नाउ सी दिस वन, कैश गोज आउट एंड गुड्स कम्स इन. If I see here debit the receiver, credit the giver, so receiver and giver is not here. If I see here debit all the expenses and losses, credit all the incomes and profit, it is also not here. Now come to the middle one, debit what comes in. So comes in means this one, so this will be goods, goods you have purchased, so it means purchase account, and as it is comes in, it means debit. And students goes out means credit, and cash goes out, so it means cash account credit. This is what the journal entry is. Students, normally we write the journal entries in the table, in the column, in the tabular form, but because this is just the beginning, so we are writing casually right now. When we will learn all the things perfectly, we will write down in the table also by drawing the lines. One more transaction that we write, students, here. Sold goods of rupees 5000 to Patel. Any name you can take, Patel, Patil, or maybe Rohan, Mohan, Sohan, Rehman, Amir, whatever name you can take. But we'll take one example of Patel. Sold goods of rupees 5000 to Patel. Now students, first we have to give twofold effect. First our criteria is whether it's an economic transaction or not. Definitely it's an economic transaction just because it is affecting the business directly. Second thing is that the main purpose of this transaction should be a profit. Purpose I am saying. So that's why this is a cash transaction. It's an economic transaction. Now the question is whether it's a cash transaction or not. So just check here. The name of the party is given, that is Patel. And because check and cash word is also not there, even paid and received word is also not there. So this is a credit transaction. Ye udhar hai. It means cash will not go also, cash will not come also. So now the next step is goods comes in or goes out. आप चेक कीजिए यहाँ पे आपने goods को क्या किया है, sell यानी sold. Sold means goods will go out. So I will write out here goods goes out. ये पहला हो गया. चलो goods गया, असल तो गई नहीं है, goods गया, goods आएगा भी नहीं. अब next step हमारा है ये income है या expense है as per the rules. अब देखिए students, अगर आप goods purchase करेंगे तो आपको पैसे देने पड़ेंगे, मगर यहाँ पे गुड्स आपने सेल किया है, सोल्ड, इट मीन मनी विल कम, तो नॉर्मली तो ये इनकम है, लेकिन यहाँ पे ये क्रेडिट ट्रांजेक्शन है, उधार है, मतलब अभी तक हमें पैसे मिले नहीं है, इट मीन्स इनकम इज स्टिल नॉट देयर, तो अभी इनकम नहीं हुई है, एक्सपेंस तो है ही नहीं. अब लास्ट स्टेप हमारा है कि भाई रिसीवर एंड गिवर, तो यहाँ पे रिसीवर कौन है, गुड्स अगर सेल किया है तो receiver is Patel and giver we people, our business is giving. So Patel is a receiver. Patel is a receiver. So students, as per the rules, just check. Goods goes out. तीन में से अगर आप देखिए तो goes out मुझे यहां दिख रहा है, this one. And उसको क्या करते हैं, credit. So goods goes out. क्यों कुछ गया, आउट बिकॉज ऑफ सेल. सो आई विल राइट डाउन योर सेल्स अकाउंट क्रेडिट. नाउ पटेल इज अ रिसीवर. अब रिसीवर यहां पे नहीं है, यहां देखिए डेबिट द रिसीवर एंड क्रेडिट द गिवर, तो डेबिट करना है क्योंकि रिसीवर है, तो पटेल इज अ रिसीवर, पटेल अकाउंट डेबिट. और एक बात स्टूडेंट, जर्नल एंट्री का रूल क्या है, अगर टू फोल्ड इफेक्ट में दो ही ट्रांजेक्शन आप लिखते हैं, दो ही इफेक्ट लेते हैं, और अगर एक डेबिट आ गया तो दूसरा क्रेडिट होगा ही, या फिर एक अगर क्रेडिट हो गया तो दूसरा डेबिट होगा ही, दोनों क्रेडिट या दोनों डेबिट नहीं हो सकते. ओके, सो दिस इज द ट्रांजेक्शन इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. Students, my humble request to you, before we go more further, better you copy these things in the notebook so that it should be there in your record for a long time. Now, students, one last transaction of today I'm going to write here. Paid salary rupees 8,000 to Raj. यानी राज को 8,000 सैलरी हमने पे की. स्टूडेंट्स, इज इट इकोनॉमिक ट्रांजेक्शन और नॉन इकोनॉमिक? ऑलरेडी यू हैव पेड द सैलरी, सो इट्स अफेक्टिंग बिजनेस, इट्स एन इकोनॉमिक ट्रांजेक्शन. सेकंड क्वेश्चन विल कम इज दैट इज अ कैश ट्रांजेक्शन और क्रेडिट ट्रांजेक्शन. स्टूडेंट, यहाँ पे एक वर्ड आ गया है पे. भले पार्टी का नाम है राज, लेकिन ये वर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट है पे. इट मीन्स ऑलरेडी मनी हैज गिवन, सो इट्स अ कैश ट्रांजेक्शन. Now, students, when you give the salary to someone, cash comes in or cash goes out? The thing is, cash goes out. Cash goes out. Second thing, पैसे गए तो कुछ आएगा? नहीं, आ नहीं रहा है. सैलरी पे की है, कुछ परचेस थोड़ी किया है. ओके, चलो, एसेट या कुछ आ भी नहीं रहा है, जा भी नहीं रहा है. ओके, अब नेक्स्ट स्टेप है हमारा, इज इट इनकम और एक्सपेंस? इनकम तो बिल्कुल नहीं है, एक्सपेंस है सैलरी. यहां पर मैं लिखूंगा, आई विल राइट डाउन, सैलरी इज एन एक्सपेंस. सैलरी इज एन एक्सपेंस. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, कैश गोज आउट, यहां लिखे गोज आउट क्या है? क्रेडिट. सो आई विल राइट डाउन हियर, कैश अकाउंट क्रेडिट. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, अब यहां देखिए, सैलरी इज एन एक्सपेंस. अब वो यहां पे एक्सपेंस, एन एक्सपेंस में क्या होता है? डेबिट. So here I will write down salary account here. So students, transaction number 1, 2, and 3 I have done today for you people. Still, it's just the beginning. Yeah, अभी शुरुआत है. It will take some time to understand the journal entry. It will take around 15-20 days. So my humble request to student, please copy this in your notebook. And any question, any doubts if you have, you can ask anytime by using comment option also, as well as by helpline number also. Thank you very much.